Welcome to ARW. I'm Harold, and I'm doing a voiceover because I really messed up the audio on this thing, fooling around with various settings. And anyway, the purpose of this video is to ask you guys to give me some ideas. You know, I've got this little shed out in the backyard, and the plywood foundation under it is gotten rotten. I need to pick it up and move it and redo the foundation. Now, what I had thought about doing was to make an A-frame and make a little roller to go on the A-frame and pull the thing up with a chain hoist and slide it to the other end of a 2x6 or whatever I've got on top of the A-frame and set it down, and then I can get right at the foundation and I can tear it all up and replace it. I decided what I want to do is to replace it with 8x16 concrete blocks. No wood under there at all. That way it can't get rotten again. It seems like that, right at the front of the door here, the thing's rotted out. Now, that's the shed that's got to be moved. And that little booger weighs right at 560 pounds. And that should show up on the screen somewhere along here. But nevertheless, that's the shed to be moved. That's where it's sitting. And I had thought probably to move it to the left on the screen, the left side of the screen there, and set it down. But that could be problematic because that little tree there has got limbs that are reaching back that way, and they might get in the way of moving the thing. Of course, I could get me a chainsaw and cut the limbs off. But I had thought about moving it sideways there and setting it down beside the fence, the wood fence. And of course, there's another alternative. I could move it straight backwards. What I'd have to do is that little fence that's beside it there, I'd have to take that fence. Let me move a bit up here and zoom in on it. I'd have to remove that little fence, which is not a big deal. It's just, a metal pole stuck in the ground and a few tie wraps. And I could move it back there into no man's land, into the utility easement. So there's two directions I could move it, and the how I move it, that's what I'm asking you guys to tell me. Do I build an A-frame that stretches twice as long as the shed and move it backwards, or make one that's twice as long as the shed and move it sideways, or do I put some handles on it somewhere or another and hire a bunch of guys to pick it up and move it? Like I say, it's 560 pounds, so it'd take at least four guys to pick it up and move it. And I've got to get it. I don't tell me to go and take it apart because I had enough trouble putting it together as it is. So we gotta move it or something, some way.
Place.
Thing you're coming right on along. I finally got all of the pavers to touch the 2x4s, and the levels looking pretty good.
I'll take this little piece of keystock and I'll probe those holes there. The rain runs right down the door and right into those holes that you see there. That one I tried to plug up. That, you see the keystock goes down in there because the wood under there is rotted out. And it goes down in there because the wood's all rotted out there too. Excuse me. So, undoubtedly, I've got to do something to make it where it'll hold together for me. I've got to have something under it because every time I drive a little lawn tractor up there, that floor wants to cave in. So that's why I'm thinking about putting the bottom of it, total concrete blocks, all one gets right up against the other. No wood or anything under it that can rot. Nothing underneath to cure if it gets wet or not. That's my plan. So what I put under it, you can make suggestions about that too, but I kind of figure that's what I'm doing. Now back here, I got a possum living under there. I can't show you the hole he's got, but he's got a hole about halfway down there. Pretty sure he's living in there. Before I forget it, the ARW discussion will be going on this Sunday at 3 p.m. Central Standard Time. And if I'm lucky, I'll have a really special guest. If I'm not, we'll still have a special panel here to talk to you. And we'll discuss something that everybody's interested in, I'm sure. Maybe several things. See y'all Sunday, 3 p.m.